capital of Wales and the surrounding county of South Glamorgan, is at the centre of the South Wales industrial conurbation, one of the most dynamic growth regions in the United Kingdom. Once the largest coaling port in the world, the steam coal of the Welsh valleys powered the merchant fleets of two continents. Cardiff was quick to realise that with the rapid post-war emergence of alternative energy sources, a closed economy could be dangerous to the well-being of the future. This was not to deny the continuing importance of coal, simply to recognise the need to strengthen the economic base of the city, and in the process, create a new dimension of prosperity for the 400,000 people who now call South Glamorgan their home. The result has been a conscious effort, supported by successive governments, to provide a twin base for the expansion of the county and indeed of the South Wales economy. On the one hand, by creating a strong and viable commercial and service industry. On the other, by encouraging diversification in both light and heavy industries. Both of these objectives, Cardiff has met and is meeting with increasing success, not only in establishing the city as a major commercial growth point, but also in attracting a broad range of new industries into the South Glamorgan catchment area. The reasons for this success are manifold. Ease of communication, modern port facilities, the cost and availability of prime development sites. But one is outstanding, the supply and the skills of the labour force available within the sub-region. Which is not to be wondered at, for since coal and iron were first mined in the valleys, South Wales has been a crucible of industry. And the men and women who have made this region great have learned to adapt their skills to the momentum of change. May sound familiar, almost a cliche of industrial marketing, but in the case of both Cardiff and its surrounding county, there are significant variations on the traditional theme, for as a capital, the city is not simply one more anonymous outcrop of an industrial or commercial economy. It is, essentially, a place for living, the beneficiary of a highly developed cultural and social life that at one and the same time is both cosmopolitan and essentially Welsh. Dr. Johnson, who once talked of a city for the whole man, he would have taken pleasure in Cardiff and its surrounding countryside.
And what I want to say is, welcome to Cardiff. Come and see us. We'd like to see you. I don't pretend that everything you saw there happens every day. It doesn't. Nor I can't even promise that the sun shines literally every day, though we get our fair share of it. But that film is a fair film. It gives you a pretty good impression of the way we live and we work in Cardiff. So if you're thinking of setting up a factory overseas in the United Kingdom, what we say is, come and look at us in Cardiff. Incidentally, there are financial advantages about coming to Cardiff. We are in a special area, and therefore we get some financial assistance for new plants and new machinery if you're thinking of coming. Cardiff's renowned for a number of things. You've seen the sports, the theatre, the art, the sculpture, the music. It's all there. And I think we live a very rounded and full life in Cardiff. You may ask, how should I know? Well, I've been the Member of Parliament for 30 years, lived there for that time. And from where I live, I can look on one side up to the mountains and to the valleys, and on the other side I can see the glistening sea and the Bristol Channel. And we do think we've got a pretty good place there. What's more, we've got a very skilled labour force. You saw a few of the industries on the film. Well, it's been trained over many years, and we pride ourselves on our labour force there. But above all, what I want to say to you is, if you come, you'll get a real Welsh welcome. We want to see you. We'd be glad to welcome you. And what is more, we'd give you every help in setting up your factory, your workshop, your office, or whatever it is you want to do.